is managing our restaurant is time taking. Checking the food status, billing, and many more things is getting hectic. Are you also tired of all these things? Not anymore. I have a solution to all your problems. Let's watch it how. Hi, myself Nishtha. In this video, we'll discuss WooCommerce Restaurant Kitchen POS. It allows the kitchen user to set the status of the food on hold, preparing, or completed. Customer can check the status of their food which they have ordered, whether it is preparing or completed, and can enjoy their food on dine-in and takeaway. Admin can also set all of these things from the admin backend panel. Now let's see how to set up POS and meet all our expectations to run our business more efficiently. But before we know more about this, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for getting the latest update from us. Apart from this, I would like to mention that if you need extensions for increasing the sales of your e-commerce store, then you can visit store.webcool.com and explore our number of products for every technology. We also have the user guide for the same in our blog sections, from where you can check the features and configuration and get to know the functionality of the extensions as well. Now let's move back to our video. Now here on the admin backend panel, we are having the username and password. With the help of this, we're going to log in. Click on login. You can see the dashboard is appear on the left hand side panel. There is an option of restaurant POS. Click on that, and here you can see n number of options are there. You have to click on users. In the user, if you want to add a new user, you can click on add new user and can enter all the details like username, first name, telephone, password, and the username profile. Select the outlet, centralized shop, last name, email, status, active or deactive, and the user role. That means which kind of role you want to give this user, a POS user or a kitchen user. So once you enter all these details, you have to click on save user. Once you save the user, it will appear here on the POS user list. And if in case if you want to edit or do any kind of changes in the existing one, so you can see here the image, the username, the outlet, the status, date created, and the role of the users is mentioned. So if you want to change the settings of the POS user, you can click on the POS user edit option, or if you want to change the kitchen user, so you can click on edit option on the kitchen user. And from here you can do the changes which you want to change and then click on the update user. Once you click on the update user, the changes will going to update. If you want to take any action in bulk, so you can just check the inbox and can active or deactivate and can apply. So this action will be taken in the bulk on the POS user and the kitchen users as well. The next option is outlets. Click on the outlets. If you want to add a new outlet, so you can click on the add new outlet, and here you can enter all the details like outlet name, select status, active or deactivate, and outlet state, outlet country, select invoice template, outlet address, outlet city, outlet postcode, and additional payment options. Once you enter all these details, you have to click on save outlet, and once you click on save outlet, it will appear on the outlet list. And if in case if you want to manage the existing outlet, so here you can see the details like outlet name, outlet address, payment method, outlet template, status, report, and the customer screen. So click on the manage outlet. From From here, you can select the product which will going to appear on the customer's end. That means which are in stock or out of stock. You can change the status of the products from here, from the backend. You can see the status is enabled. If you disable the product status, so it won't appear on the customer end on the front end. If you want to take any action bulk, you can select the checkbox and can enable and disable all the products once, just clicking on apply. The next option is general settings. So in the general settings, you can see the settings which I have shown you once you add a new outlet. So from here, if you want to change any kind of settings in the existing outlets, so you can change the setting and can click on update outlet. Then next is customer screen. That means whatever will be going to visible on the customer screen, you can manage it from here. Preparing text and the completed text. Your order is under preparing. Hope you enjoy your order. That means once the order is preparing, so the text will be your order is under preparing. And once the order is completed, so the text will be hope you enjoy your order. This will going to reflect to the customer once the order is prepared or completed. Customer screen visible status. Enable video option. If you want, the customer can see the video of any of the product, so you can check this box. We don't want to show any kind of video to the customer, so we're not going to check this box. Image display mode, portrait or landscape. Side image, the image which will going to reflect on the page on the side. You can select which image should be represent on the side of the page. The slideshow images, here the images in case of video disabled, then you can upload the slideshow of the images for the POS customer screen. Otherwise, you can also leave it as blank. Slideshow bottom images, that means the images which will going to move on the bottom of the page. You can change the images from here and can upload the new images. Once you're done with all the changes, you can click on save changes. So the next option we're going to see is dining tables. Click on dining tables. From here, you can add a new dining table if you want to. Click on add new option. And here you have to enter the name, select outlet, status, enable, disable, select type, square, circle and rectangle. Seats, how many seats will be there in the table, and then click on save tables. Once you click on save tables, it will going to appear here on the table list. And if you want to change the existing table, so you can click on the edit option and can do the changes and can update the settings. If you want to delete, so you can click on delete the table. And from here, you can also change the status in bulk by clicking on the checkbox and clicking on the enable, disable or delete, and can click on apply. The action will be taken on the selected checkbox or on the selected tables. Here you can see the table name, type, outlet, seats, how many seats are there, status, enable or disable, and the bookings, like how many bookings are there, you can check from the backend from here. The next option we'll see is settings. Click on settings. And under settings, click on kitchen and customer screen. Here you can see the Firebase details. These Firebase details are needed to transfer the live data. So you need to enter these Firebase details so that the live data can be transferred. So this was much about the admin backend panel. Now let me show you the kitchen user panel, or the POS user panel and the customer user panel as well. First, we're going to see the POS user, then the kitchen user, and then the customer user panel. Here I'm on the POS user panel, and from here we're going to log in. You need to add a certain amount from which you're going to log in, like I'm adding. Now you can purchase or add your product to cart in two ways, like in dine-in, and if you want to take away, so you can go for takeaway option as well. And in that also, there are two options. That means add to prepare and those few food which does not need to prepare or don't have a need of preparation. So you can just pay for them. So let me show you how you can do that. For example, I'm adding this product on cart and this won't need any kind of preparation. So we're going to click on pay option. Here we have to enter the amount and then just click on confirm payment and generate invoice. The order has been successfully placed. That means the order has been placed and have been delivered to the customer as well without any delay. And in case if you are ordering any kind of food which needs preparation, so for example, I'm adding this and then you have to click on pay option. Here you can see the option is add to prepare. You have to check this box so that this food can send to kitchen user for the preparation purpose. And now enter the amount, confirm payment and generate invoice. The order has been successfully placed. Now you can click on skip, or if you want to print invoice, you can click on print invoice. Now let me show you how it will going to reflect on the kitchen user panel. Here you can see I'm on the kitchen user panel. I'm going to log in. The option is there. That means the kitchen user have to start preparing, or if the food has been completed, so he can transfer the food to completed and preparing as well. Once I click on start, the food is sent to preparing. And if in case you want to see how it will going to reflect this preparing option on the customer end, so let me show you that also. This is the customer end. Here you can see the food has been preparing, and once it will completed, it will shift towards the completed side. Now the kitchen user will send this food to completed and now send back to the POS user so that the POS user can deliver the food to the customer. Now we are on the POS user. Here we can check the food has been delivered or not by clicking on the dining tables, sent orders. Here you can see the food has been sent to the customer and the delivery is completed. So now let me show you how you can go all these steps on the dine-in option. So for that, click on here on the right hand side, dine-in. Now select the tables. Whichever table you want, you can select it from here. Now enter the customer name, booking date, available booking slot. Now click on book. Table booked successfully. Okay. Now click on bookings. And you can see the table which we have booked recently is there. Click on expand. Now from here you can add the products to your table. So click on add product. In this also, if you are ordering any food which doesn't need any kind of preparation, it will going to generate quickly. And if you are ordering any kind of food which needs preparation, then it will take time. So first, let me show you how you can add your food without any preparation. So I'm adding this. Now we have to click on pay. Enter the amount. Confirm payment and generate invoice. The order has been placed successfully. The order has been sent to the customer's table without any delay. Now let me show you how you can order a product or a food which needs preparation. So for that, we need to select table first. Click on tables. Select any of the table. Write down the customer name, booking date, available booking slot, and then click on book. Table booked successfully. Now go on bookings. From here, click on expand and add your product to your table. Now you have to click on add to prepare. You don't have to pay for the food first. First, the food will prepare and will going to serve you on the table, and then you can pay for the same. So click on add to prepare. If you want to give any kind of any note to the kitchen user, so you can add here. This is showing on hold right now because the kitchen user haven't started preparing. So let me show you on the kitchen user end as well. See, it is reflecting on the kitchen user that it is not started yet. So once the kitchen user click on start, now it's on preparing and then completed. So this, the same status of the food will going to reflect on the customer end as well. Let me show you how it is going to reflect. You can see the order ID and the status of the food is that it is completed. So the customer can check like this, the completing process or the preparing process as well. Moving back to our POS user panel, here we can see on the dining table, sent order option is there. Click on sent order option. The food has been prepared from the kitchen user panel and have been sent it to the POS user back so that the POS user can serve this food to the customer. Now the food has been sent to the customer and the POS user can create the bill for the same by clicking on create bill option. From here you need to enter the amount, confirm payment and generate invoice. If you want to print the invoice, you can click on print invoice. That's it for now. Like the same way, you can also manage your restaurant with the help of WooCommerce Restaurant Kitchen POS. And also, if you want to know more about this restaurant POS, you can view our previous video as well. I have attached the video link in the comment section below. For any further query, suggestion or doubt, you can reach us at support@webcool.com or you can raise a ticket at webcool.ubdesk.com. And also, if you found this video helpful, do like it and share your views in the comment section below. See you all in our next video. Till then, thanks for watching. Good day.